I don't see that really as an argument either. So the whole is more than the sum of the parts. That's okay. The question is whether this whole has some moral values that the single parts don't have. And if it does, then where does the value come from? So as an organism, yeah, the way it functions is different from the way each single part functions. But that's just a functionalist explanation, which I accept. But why would this more complex being acquire some sort of moral status? Where does it come from? So this was in part addressed her question before. So as I said before, the question we need to ask is where does the value come from? And I don't see this as an argument for the origin of this value. And I have to say that you were disappointed by the argument from the side. I didn't hear any convincing argument, any challenging argument on the pro-life side either. What Peter did was just offering some assertion about the moral goodness of nature. I don't see any reason for that. I agree with many points that Joe made, but I didn't agree with the way they apply to the abortion debate. So even in this case, I can ask, where does that value come from? And I haven't found any answer to this question from the pro-life side. So
from the accumulation. Okay.
Yeah, but accumulation is a factual thing. So as a matter of fact, that's an accumulation. Yeah. But where does the value come from? When do the value get into this picture? I can't see it.
I would have to agree with Alberto on that. So we've got consensus. I don't think that accumulation of complexity makes any difference, morally speaking. But what I said originally to my argument was not the moral goodness of nature. Nature, in of itself, does not have moral goodness. Rather, it's the fulfillment of human flourishing by virtue of the fact that we are rational human beings with intellect and free will. And when we don't have the actualizing of those potentialities of our nature, it's of course our parents who have that responsibility to enable us to flourish. It's got nothing to do with the moral goodness of nature. It's about how do we find moral norms as human beings, and that is within the purposes within our nature, the fulfillment of which constitute human flourishing. And that's the argument you haven't dealt with. So natural law argument, which as you say is a rather typical argument, I'm surprised you haven't been able to rightly characterize it and therefore respond to it.
Thank you very much.